And then you look at the names that God gives. God speaks to the Hebrew man named Shimon, Simon, and says, you will now be called Kepha or Petros in Greek. You are the rock. Well, he wasn't a rock. He was shaky. If anybody was, he was rocky. He was not a rock. But he was called the rock. Why? Because he would become the rock. You look at the end of his life, he finally becomes the rock. He becomes solid. He becomes stable. He becomes powerful. But he was named in each case. God gives them a name before the name is accurate, before it's true, except in the heavenlies. Or he caused their parents to give them the name. And so he knew it. Even parents who might not have known the Lord, he caused it. I've noticed many times, I'm not saying always, but I noticed many times that people's names, many times the meaning matches their lives. Not always, but many. I mean, some people have pagan names. Some of you do. There are women who say, okay, my name means moon goddess. What is that? I'm sorry. We'll have a healing service for your name. And if your name Malcolm, forget it. I'm sorry that you're named after Moloch, the false god of Israel. So, I mean, we can't do anything. But for a lot of people, I've noticed that. You know, remember, of course, Gary Selman, his name, you know, he was always someone, hey, God is great, everything, God, you know, his Hebrew name is Gedaliah, which means God is great. Now, whether it matches or not, God gives you a new name. And it's not only that the angel called Gideon valiant, mighty warrior before it was true, but also even when he said Gideon, you know what Gideon meant? Gideon, or in Hebrew, Gidon. It means one who cuts down, like cuts down a mighty tree. He's the one who will cut down the Midianites. From birth, he had the name. It happens throughout the Bible. But the principle goes back to the very beginning of the Bible, the book of Genesis. Which comes first, the world or the word? The word, and then the world. So the word is more important than the world. The word, that's why it says the grass withers, the flower fades, but the word goes on no matter what happens in the world. You have the word, then you have the universe. The word is first. And the word that is given is the word of the universe, of it coming into existence. First comes the word. The word and then the reality. Not the reality and the word first. God said, Yehi or light. Let there be light, word, and then there was light, reality. So first there's the word of the light, and then there's the light itself. He had to speak the word of light in the darkness because there was no light. A contrary word, he went against the darkness. God said, before there was man, what happened? He said, let us make man in our image. The word came first, the word man. He's let us make man. What's the Hebrew word for man? Adam. Adam. So first was the word of Adam, and then was Adam the reality. First the word. Think about this. It's not just Genesis. The entire Bible is filled with this principle. And that is, the Bible is filled with prophecies. What are prophecies? They're simply words God gives before the reality. Before that. And so the Bible is filled with that. Every time you think of prophecy, it's the same principle that was in Genesis. When God said, let there be light. And then there was light after the word. Think about this. You know, Shalom and Arit just came from Israel. Israel has come back into the world. But 2,500 years before it came back in the world, God spoke it back in the world. God, just like he said, let there be light, and there was light. He said, let there be Israel, and there would be Israel. The word is there. The truth, the reality, I mean, you know, this is spoken from ancient times. 2,500 years, and then 1948, it happens, but it was spoken first, just like the universe. On the document that proclaims the rebirth of Israel, I have an original copy of what was printed on that day in my office, and it says, and if you look on it, you look around, it has illustration, it has words around the edges, and one of the words is, prophesy to these bones. It's quoting from the prophecy of Ezekiel in the Valley of Dry Bones 2,500 years ago about the resurrection of Israel. That the word of Israel, then the nation. That truth, that fills up the Bible. It's not only the principle of creation and it's the principle of prophecy, but it's the principle of your life. That is, that always comes the word and then comes everything else. Adam was told to name the animals. So God showed the animals, he gave them names. So Adam saw the reality and then he gave his own word to the reality. But God didn't do it. God said the word first and then came the thing. God speaks before the fact, but Adam spoke after the fact. So in the natural, as children of Adam, in the natural, we live that way. We see things and then we give the word to it. In other words, let me show you. You have a day, everything goes wrong, you have the your tire goes flat, you get a letter from the IRS, you have your dog bites someone, they're suing you. You say, I had a bad day. You are naming the reality. The reality happened and you gave a name to it. Okay? If you had a good day, someone was nice to you, they're a nice person. Okay, you gave the word to the reality. You're doing well, I'm doing well today. Because I'm doing well, I say I'm doing well, then I gave a word reflecting the reality. If I feel bad, I feel bad. If I feel good, I say I'm feeling good. If things happen in the news, you say that's what happened. Sounds good. You're being truthful. Your word is following the reality, okay. That's natural, but that's not supernatural. That's human, but that's not divine. That's not God. To live in the power of God, I mean, there's a realm for that, of course, but to live in the power of God, the word doesn't follow the reality. The reality follows the word.
To find out how you can receive more of Jonathan's teachings, to receive special free gifts, or get in touch, go to hopeoftheworld.org or call toll-free 1-800-YESHUA-1. That's hopeoftheworld.org or call 1-800-YESHUA-1. That's 1-800-937-4821. You can also get more at Jonathan Cahn's Facebook page or write us direct at Hope of the World, Box 1111, Lodi, New Jersey, 07644, USA. Hope of the World is dedicated to the goal of spreading God's word and salvation to every land and people. We do this by spreading the word throughout the world and sponsoring compassion projects to the most poor and needy around the earth. To get in touch or have a part in God's work, just write to Hope of the World, Box 1111, Lodi, New Jersey, 07644, USA. Or go to hopeoftheworld.org or call 1-800-YESHUA-1. That's 1-800-937-4821.